Now, we've been following the global economy, and we realize that most of the numbers that these governments put out, they're completely fake, phony, and false. And we've shown how they manipulate these numbers very, very easily. Now, out in the EU, we can see that the unemployment rate really hasn't changed since 2009. Youth unemployment is very, very high in many EU countries, despite everything they try to do to fix the problem. Now, the problem is that there's no jobs. The problem is these countries are going into debt. The problem is the central banks are ordering austerity. And when you put all this together, you get a situation which, guess what? It cannot be a robust type of an economy. They destroy economies. They don't make them better. And this is exactly what we're seeing now. Here in the United States, what they've done is they've completely manipulated the statistical numbers. They make everyone believe that the economy's doing well. They make everyone believe that, kids are going to college and they're getting a good education. They're coming out and they're getting jobs, which we know this is fake, phony, and false because we know the number of college students and the youth who are graduating high school, they are living with their parents longer and longer and longer. And we know that they've been modifying the student loans because most of these people can't pay back their student loans. And what's very interesting about the student loan market is that basically the government, well, they can't bail out the student loan market. So they figured out a way of how to bail out the student loan market and make individuals purchase homes. Now remember, they need to push, and I'm talking about the central bank, they need the people of the United States to take out more and more debt. They also need the ability to get rid of those individuals that are defaulting, and they need a bailout for that. So how did they do this? Well, home builder Lennar, they've come up with a genius strategy to partially eliminate the massive bubble in the student loan market. Because a lot of graduates, guess what? They can't find high-paying jobs. They might have one or two part-time jobs or one low-paying job, and their student loans are, quite a bit, and they are having a very difficult time making their loan payments. Even though the government came in and they modified their loan amount and they projected it out over the number of years where they can have this payout, people are still having a very rough time in doing this. So Lennar developed an innovative mortgage design to allow millennials the opportunity to convert their student loan debt into investment in America. How are they going to do this? Well, they're going to purchase a home. They're going to take out a mortgage. And Lennar, guess what? I guess they're going to integrate that student loan into the mortgage. They'll have a house, they'll have the mortgage, and they'll be able to get rid of the student loan debt and purchase a home and basically extend the debt even further. Now, Lennar is set to introduce the new promotion that will make payments on buyer student loans equal to 3% of their purchase price up to $13,000 in return for purchasing a new Lennar home. And it's simple as that. So Lennar will make payments to a buyer student loan of as much as 3% of the purchase price up to $13,000. Now, who's guaranteeing this? Well, Fannie Mae, a government-sponsored enterprise, has agreed to back the new innovative loans from Lennar. Now, we can see at this point that these individuals who are having a very tough time paying their student loans or will purchase the house, this is a desperate attempt to get people to purchase homes. Because if the housing market and the job market was so great, they wouldn't be doing all of this. They wouldn't go to the sub-subprime level. They wouldn't be making these programs up. And we can see that this is going to go all wrong once the entire system starts to break apart, which it is breaking apart right now. And this is how desperate they're getting. So we can see right now, this is exactly what they are doing. And they're going to try to help the situation in the student loan market while pushing the sales of homes, while pushing the debt level even larger. Because think about it. These individuals, if they have student loans of $30,000, they're going to pay up $13,000, plus they're taking out a mortgage, so their payment is even larger than it was once before. Now, it sounds good, but we can see right now that this whole thing is going to come to a screeching halt when everything starts to completely fall apart, and all these individuals that get in on this program, just like back in 2007, 2008, when all these people started to buy all these different homes at, you know, 0% interest, and they're buying house after house. This seems like we're heading down the same path, and it's going to be a complete and utter disaster. Now, we understand that Russia and China, they are insuring their wealth by continually buying gold, actually trading the U.S. dollar in for gold. And the Central Bank of Russia has more than doubled the pace of gold purchases over the past decade, adding more than 1,200 tons to its gold reserves, and this is according to the World Gold Council data. Now, in the second quarter alone, it accounted for 38% of all gold purchases by the central banks. And we can also see that China is doing the same thing, where they're continually hoarding gold because right now it's very, very inexpensive, and they understand that this is going to ensure the country. And we see right now that both countries and many other countries are doing the same exact thing, because they understand that the dollar is not going to survive that much longer. And everyone should be looking at this saying and scratching their head saying, well, if they're purchasing or trading in the dollar for all this gold, maybe we should do the same. Maybe we should buy some type of precious metal. Maybe we should insure our wealth somehow, some way, and do exactly what the other countries or central banks are doing. And we need to understand that this just didn't happen yesterday. This has been an ongoing process since 2009, 2010, where they continually added more and more gold to their vaults. And they've been preparing for a very long time. Now, we've been following this for quite a while, and we realize that Russia created a payment system, China's created a payment system. They understand that they bypassed the dollar, they started a trade amongst their own currency. China introduced the Shanghai Gold Exchange. They duplicated the markets out in China. And we see that this was all done on purpose, and this wasn't done overnight. This was done over a period of time, because they knew it was going to take a while to do all of this, and this was planned from the very beginning. Just like when the United States became the reserve currency back in 1947, this was planned way ahead of schedule. This wasn't something that they say, hey, you know what? Let the dollar become the reserve currency. This was planned way ahead back in the early 30s, and it took a very long time to get the planning done and everything set. And of course, they had this event, which was called World War II, where they pretty much covered up what was going on. And they allowed the system to reset, where the United States took the gold from all the countries, and the central banks decided, okay, now we have a new reserve currency, we'll hold on to the gold, we'll basically peg the dollar to the gold, and eventually what we'll do is we'll remove the peg at a later date. And this is exactly what they do. The central banks, they are very patient. They understand that they don't need to rush and do things. They make a lot of money in between, and they realize that they can be very patient, they can be very methodical, and they can wait a period of time before they act. And we've seen this time and time again. And the preparation for this new reserve currency, which might be the SDR, it might be a cryptocurrency, it might be a combination of both, we can see that this has been planned for quite a while. We've been following it. This is the reason why we're checking and watching this every single day, so we understand and we know what is going on. This is why you need to be ready and prepared. Yes, to everyone else, it's going to seem like this just happened. We might have some type of an event, and after the event, you know, something will change, and everyone's going to sit there going, wow, because we had this, no longer can the U.S. be the reserve currency because the financial institutions were hit by some type of an attack or something happened, and this is why it's moving to the IMF or moving to China, wherever it's going to be. And we'll understand, because we've been watching this, that no, this didn't happen because of that. This was planned from the very beginning. And this is why you need to be prepared from the very beginning, because you don't want to be left out there saying, oh, I wish I bought gold. I wish I bought silver. I wish I bought some cryptocurrency. I wish I kept dollars on hand. I wish I had some food, some water, some supplies so I can barter. Just like when a storm approaches, all those people said, eh, it's not going to hit. I don't really care. It's not going to be that big of a deal. I don't need to prep. And then all of a sudden the storm hits. Yes, some people didn't get hit that badly. The other people, well, it's a complete disaster, and they're sitting there going, wow, I wish I had a flashlight. I wish I had some drinking water. I wish I had boarded up my house. I wish I done and taken these steps to prevent what is coming. And the same thing is going to happen. And this is going to be an economic type of disaster. And you need to be ready and prepared for this, because one day, and this day is getting closer and closer, it's just going to hit. You will have no time to do anything. When the hurricane was approaching Texas and Florida, guess what? People ran out to get fuel before the storm was coming. The lines were very, very long. A lot of the pumps ran out of fuel. People were going into supermarkets buying water. The shelves were completely empty. Very difficult to find water. And this was for a hurricane. Can you imagine what would happen in an economic disaster where credit freezes up? Supplies aren't coming in. The dollar is devalued and we're hit with inflation. Do you think people are just going to sit back? No, they're going to go crazy. They're going to do exactly what they did when the hurricanes were approaching, but they're going to be a lot more scared. Why? Because that water, that loaf of bread, and everything else is going to continually move up in price, and they're going to scramble to get these supplies. So you don't want to be left out in the cold. You don't want to wait for this to happen. You want to be ready and prepared for what is coming. Listen, everyone, thanks a lot for listening. Be well, be safe, and especially be prepared.